gold earrings, a gold necklace, or maybe just something simpler. Hair up, or maybe head down, flats or high heel shoes. Well, after about 30 minutes, I was getting a little tired of waiting. So when she asked me which dress she should choose, I told her, make up your own damn mind. You give it plenty of time. Now there ain't nothing left to do but make up your own damn mind. I says, make up your own damn mind. Woman, I could do it for you, but I think you're gonna
Where's my scab school?
That's,
yes, go. Enter is what I say.
Oh, but he double booked him last Saturday night. He had Ginny and Janie and Rhonda. And when he asked me which one he should take,
get out of here. Be gone with you.
I told him, make up your own damn mind. You're gonna have a real nice time.
How does it look? Yeah, of course I want to click the or close the whatever. All right. It should be in 720p. That's what everything's set at. That's the question. Is it at? In the rain or in the snow, I got the funky, funky flow. I've been working here since my mama was a baby. Just because the rhythm is slow, that don't mean you can't flow. In the rain or in the snow, in the rain or in the snow. Booty, 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 booty. Come on, what you got? You got any music? Let me know that the audio is working. Well, tell me if you're able to figure out whether or not it's 720p. Of course, there's no audio for this one, or there's no words. I also have... Wait, am I supposed to start doing something? That'd be so like them. To make it to where I'm already supposed to be doing something, but I don't even know what I'm supposed to do. Except for, here I am. There we go. What? And then we'll go... As per standards? What do you mean by as per standards? Look, man, I don't even speak Spanish. Yeah, man, let's do this. Let's journey. New journey. Pressing the start button. Is that what's happening? This is loading time? I thought it was exposition. I was very confused. I'm like, no! Loading times shouldn't take any time at all. You just click things and they go amazing and fast and just magic. Brant, how does it look down there? Yeah, I have actually. It's pretty... There's parts that are great about this, but there's parts that are really, like, I'm just like, this is really the game I'm playing? Yeah, that's great. Glad to hear that.
goodness gracious me.
Do you speak bocce? What? Oh, you could tilt left and right? I don't really like six-axis business. I'm not a fan. This seems... I guess I'm supposed to... There we go. Apparently that's an important thing. Can I jump? What did I just do? Online play disabled? Well, hell yeah. Sure. Oh, I'm gonna have to get like a login and shit for that, don't I? Should I play by myself? Should I play with myself? Or should I actually sign up for one of these crazy things? No, sand people are Tusken Raiders. I was making a Jawa joke. Totally different. How many frames per second are we getting? I am king of this hill. None shall take it from me. Wait, there's a bigger hill? I can't handle knowing there's a bigger hill than my hill. I just pace all night long, wondering, what about this hill? You think you're better than me, hill? Oh, I can't even look at you. You disgust me. Still there! Oh, God, maybe if I hide, but if I look through this hole, if I look through this hole, are you still bigger? Still bigger. I hate you, hill! Up there mocking, taller than the sun. You think you're so great? Just a big, dumb rock. Far, I bet you're not even that big if I got up close. Fine, I'm gonna go over there. I'm on a quest to show you're not so big, hill. My little hill at the beginning was just as good as you. These are the graves of all those who've come before me. Think they're better than me? You're not better than me either, hill. I have Hill Street blues. It's a real affliction. Look in the dictionary. Under blues, comma Hill Street. Alright, what you got? Yes. I want your tickets. Give me your magic tickets. Thank you. Yes. I need a scarf. I need to look fabulous. That's not a scarf, that is a tail. Give me these pieces too. Yes, that will do nicely. Yes. Now I have the power of flight. I'm coming for you, hill. I can't jump now. I have one lousy power to jump. Now I can't do it. Come here. Hey, guys. I need your juice. Thank you. Whee! Alright, a little bit more. Thank you, top me off. Ooh, there's more over there. What? Little ticket birds. I need two for Lynyrd Skynyrd. Ticket birds. StubHub. Thank you. Yes. Now I slide like the wind. Eat shit, mountain. What? Can you do this, mountain? I don't think so, because you ain't got legs. You need legs to use them like this. And I don't need your big glowing, brighter than the sun trick over there either. I got glowing things here on Earth, in English. Oh my gosh, there's nothing worse than cage scalpers. Cage scalpers. Yes. Yeah, now my dog is alone. What's wrong? I could climb like the wind to the highest peak and be recharged. Yes, I don't know what I did, but it was good. Be free, StubHub! Go scalp your tickets as far as the wind will fly. Hold on, Justin Robert Young is gone. Okay, all right. All right, I'm live. You guys want to do this in front of the whole world? All right. Yeah, we'll just figure some shit out. All right, I'll call you a bit. Okay, all right, all right. Yeah, well, I ain't got no multiplayer members. And in fact, I'm gonna have to pause it. Pause the game. I wish I could sign. No, I just wanna pause the game. Sure, we'll say select for options. And then I'm gonna pause the game. And then I'm gonna... shoot. I'm in like in high def, I just realized. Which is gonna be a problem. If I'm going to get one, just Robert Young on the line. I'm going to have to stop the stream and restart it. So give me just a moment. I'm going to blurga and then I'll blurga blurga. So be right back. Badoop boop beep badoop. Then I'm going to call one Justin Robert Young. My dream is to call Justin Robert Young and make all the comedy there ever was. There it is.
Yes.
Yo.
Yes. Hello.
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 It's Bane. Yes, that's my name. Ask me again. I'll tell you the same. Let me explain. Or what is it? What's the, why the mask? Let me explain. I'm Bane.
Who is Bane. The only man to defeat me in a freestyle?
Only me. Yes.
Yes.
So, yeah, man, I'm convinced they didn't change the, they didn't edit any of that.
Oh, that's from the movie?
No. Like the video is all unedited, I think. I think they matched all the audio to exactly the existing video.
Oh, I don't know. I would suspect there were nips and tucks.
Well, that's
great because it retains that feel.
Right.
But right. I think part of it is because that scene was shot with so many of those slow tracking kind of shots.
Yeah.
That like those are very malleable. You know, it's not like they cut it to a super quick cut kind of scene where there like changes would be very noticeable. Let me open these blinds so we're not getting like crazy zebra.
Crazy zebra.
Zebra.
Oh, I thought what's funny is as you open those windows, I thought, well, now we're just going to see all the crazy zebras in the back behind you.
Hey, can you send me a video, by the way?
Oh, I should be.
I'm Bane.
All right. Let me switch. Beedy bloop, boop, boop, camera toop. And then zoobity beep, beat up, boop. So do we want to just give him the raw and then he can cut this however he wants?
Here's, I was thinking about this.
Either that or we could just nail it side by side, one take.
Well, here's what I was thinking about.
Yep.
So what we do is, number one, we need a topic.
Yes. Luckily we got the chat room on the case.
And here was my thought.
Yep.
We do like three, like we just go through it, and if we're not happy with it in terms of being super tight,
yep,
then we just do it again.
All right,
we just like let's just get it so it's like super tight.
We Groundhog like Day it. We bust a Groundhog Day.
Yeah, but I think it's got to be something that we're on the opposite end of. So, are there any current genre arguments that we are on the opposite end of? I can think of one.
What is it?
I don't know whether we're on opposite ends, but. Should there have, this was a banner year, maybe the best year ever for comic book movies.
Yeah.
And despite the fact that periodically, I mean, Batman's been, Dark Knight, I think, was nominated for Best Picture.
The best thing ever, I believe it was nominated for.
The best picture in history.
The best photograph. It actually won for every still frame in the Dark Knight.
The Ansel Adams Award.
It won, yes. Every one was, in fact, was the
Ansel
best
Adams'
picture.
Ghost was revived at every frame and said, "This kicks my dead ass. I'm Ansel Adams." I don't even know. Is Ansel Adams dead? I assume he's dead.
Moon over Half Dome. What? Screw that. Dark Knight. Did it really win a Best Picture nom?
Well, remember, it went to 10 nominations a couple years ago.
Yeah, that's too many nominations.
So, and part of the reason why is because they wanted to get some of the, like, what we call in the industry, movies anyone has seen nominated for Best Picture. And so I believe that it was nominated there. By the way, let me just say, I'm settling in very well to cohabitating life.
Oh my God. Did just wine just appear in your
People
hand?
People cook you dinners?
What?
Bring food?
Dude, what?
It's amazing.
How do you maintain a completely platonic relationship, though? I would be tempted at some point, like, to have sex.
No. You want to know what, Brian?
What?
I'm glad you asked that, because I've got the secret.
What?
Intercourse.
Wait. Is that sex?
No.
It's intercourse.
That's the way I do it, Brian.
You're like intercourse, you know, where you throw a dead fish between you and you run around the circle three times and then jerk off. That's intercourse, right?
Sure. Right. That's where you map out a drag racing roadway. Intercourse.
Oh, intercourse. Yes, of course. Okay, so what's the challenge? What's the issue?
So, I mean, should there have been a comic book movie nominated for Best Picture this year, be it Dark Knight Returns, Avengers, or Spider-Man?
Spider-Man. Man, actually, it would get personal really fast. It's hard for me to even remember the things I was annoyed with Spider-Man, though.
You know, we're not arguing the negatives.
Yes. Okay.
Unless you were saying that of the 10 that were nominated, and let's go ahead and, I mean, we would, if we were going to do this, we would look at those 10 and say that no, Avengers, Dark Knight Rises, and Spider-Man were not better than these three.
Okay. Now, but should we be arguing with each other? Because he made it sound like we should be arguing back and forth.
Oh yeah, no. That I'm trying to find something that we're on
different on footing on. Okay, yeah. let me get the list out, because you're right. We should do this. We'll do Best Picture nominations 2013.
But also, it's like genre in general. I don't think anything genre. I mean, although nothing genre is.
What does genre mean?
Genre typically is defined by science fiction, fantasy, and horror. Those are the genre films. Where are people chat room wise now, by the way? Are they
they're just in the Justin, because whenever I'm playing video games, I usually have people hang out in the Justins. Wait, except for I'm not. I'm in Unfiltered. Apparently everyone's in Unfiltered and so am I. I thought I was somewhere else, but I wasn't.
All right. I'm joining so I can watch the chit chat.
School Brian. Yeah. What? Bing, that's my name. Okay.
So we can do that. I mean,
where's the list, though?
Oh, you want me to pull up the list?
Yeah. I'm trying to find a link to the list. Chat room will have it. Like, they probably already have it.
13.
In a dark room. How come the dark room didn't win? The best pictures.
All right. Oh, wow. There's 9 best picture. Oh, no. There's Lincoln, Zero Dark Thirty, Argo, Les Miserables, Life of Pi, Silver Linings Playbook, Amour, and Django. And it's hard for me to argue with this because I haven't seen a lot of them.
I know. Same here. I'm thinking the same problem. Unless we wanted to just argue completely out of ignorance. and just be all like, how great could it be? Argo? That's not even a real word.
I mean, I haven't seen Life of Pi, but I have a feeling if there is going to be one of the movies that I will attack mercilessly as being horrifyingly overrated, it's Life of Pi. Just because
is it overrated?
The director kind of has overrated written all over him. Because by the way, as much as I kind of liked it in theaters, does anybody watch Crouching Tiger, Hidden Dragon in the last fucking 10 years? For real. Challenge me, fucking find one person.
I didn't like it. I didn't like it when it came out. And my brother was pissed. He's like, you're just doing that to be contrarian. And I'm like, no, man, I didn't like it. It's not.
I fell asleep twice.
Yeah.
It's boring.
Yeah.
Oh, Chinese people running on trees. And this is Indian God dude damn. In a boat.
Okay,
all of Ang Lee's movies can be described in one phrase: the gay cowboys, Chinese people running on trees, Indian guy in a boat.
All right, that's fair enough. Yeah, I like the fact that you didn't even put the tiger in there. It's just an Indian guy in a boat.
An Indian dude in a boat. Well, if an Indian dude's in a boat, what else is going to be there? Tiger, obviously.
I still can't find every fucking article that I'm finding is not showing me what I want to find here. So somebody post.
Well, those are though I named you them.
I know, but those are words and words that go bleh, and they go bleh, bleh, bleh.
Oh, you're just looking for a list of them?
Yeah. I'm looking for a place to see them.
I'm gonna put it in the chat room.
There you go. Cobra. Oscar, go. Life of Pi, Lincoln. Silver Linings Playbook. I don't even know what that's about.
That's about gambling with Bradley Cooper and Jennifer Lawrence.
Can we just say, instead of saying comic book movies, because that's going to be tainted anyway, certainly we could pick Looper. Can we just say all the movies that Looper is better than?
Genre movies. How about that? Okay, so but then I would have to take the contrarian view and say that Looper does not deserve a Best Picture nomination, which I don't agree with. even having not seen.
What if it's Brian and Justin fix the Oscars, and we're like, Amour, you're out, replaced with Looper.
Kind of sounds right. What if we just switch it without anybody noticing?
I don't think anyone would notice.
I mean, like, just read it. Like, Life of Pi, Silver Linings Playbook, Amour, Django Unchained. Now, hold on. Tell me if you hear anything different. Life of Pi, Silver Linings Playbook, Looper, Django Unchained. You don't even fucking hear anything.
No, it's meant to be. That's like when your body gets somebody else's heart, like an 18-year-old who was drinking and maybe got crashed on his motorcycle, and it's so close to your own heart, and it keeps on thumping. Doesn't even notice.
That doesn't work, though, because, like, normally when that happens, it's because it's like a murderer's heart. And now you have, like, the heart of a murderer. And it's like you see people to murder and everything. They never talk about the other stuff the murderer was into, though. Like, what if the murderer also liked Twix?
Yeah, and all of a sudden you suddenly start, ooh. Well, they kind of hinted that. Like,
crunch,
you know,
caramel.
He's like a pregnant woman. He just has cravings.
There's
like,
two things I like.
I want to watch reruns of Friends.
The satisfaction of a chocolatey Twix and stabbing an old woman in the heart. Hi, everybody. It's me, the Twix murderer.
I love Twix and the kill boner I get when I stab her heart.
Sometimes I like to just put my kill boner between two Twix bars. I call it the third Twix.
I call it betwixt the cheeks as I
a mystery lies betwixt
the cheeks. Okay. Well, then what do we? Wow, he gave us a list of shit to argue about.
Did he?
I don't even know if they're. Yeah, earlier. I mean, just suggestions. He just says take any classic.
So does everybody know?
It should be. It should be Oscars.
Set up what we're doing.
What's that?
Everybody knows what we're doing. We don't have to set up
what
we're doing.
Nope. Nobody knows. They're like, we're going to do a thing. By the way, I've been recording all of this, and I don't know why. I'm going to stop.
Oh. Yeah. So nobody knows who we're talking about?
Nope.
I don't like his list.
Okay. I like the fact that you retreated to safety before launching that gem. Yes. So let's fix the Oscars. If the Oscars were the genre Oscars.
Well, I mean,
why don't we do this? Why don't we say,
because I don't feel like we can name 10 great genre movies.
I know, but here's what we can do. Here's what we can do for this year. We could take them down, like see if they stand and survive. Like Django Unchained wouldn't get unseated. Django Unchained would get attacked by Cabin in the Woods and just bitch slap Cabin in the Woods down. And Django Unchained would remain at the top. Life of Pi, take on the Avengers. Lincoln would take on Looper. They both start with L's. Silver Linings Playbook would take on the Simpsons movie from 5 years ago.
Okay, I think you're losing. This one's breaking up in the atmosphere.
Yeah.
It orbited for like one revolution.
No, it was going somewhere. And then it's like when the Super Friends fight the Legion of Doom, but then like somebody didn't have his match, you know? They're all like, "Who's the guy that's the exact inverse of my capabilities?" And it wasn't there, and so they couldn't.
All right, here. I think I got the segment. Let's try to hit it in a minute and a half. I'll lead. Dance with me.
Okay. Here we go. I'll go ahead and kick it off. You take it, and then here we go. Hey, what's going on? It's Brian Brushwood.
Justin Robert Young. All right, Brian.
Hold on. Let's try.
I thought you were going to kick it off like you were going to set it up, not just say your name.
Well, that's why I'm saying it's like I just pressed record and then started talking. Here, why don't you say, "Hey, I'm Justin Robert Young. I'll see Brian Brushwood," then you go.
All right. I'm Justin Robert Young.
Hey, I'm Brian Brushwood.
Shut up.
No, you shut your face.
Oscar nominations for Best Picture, okay?
Right.
And none of them are genre movies. Now, they expanded them to 10 so you could have movies that people like and have seen, despite the fact that genre movies have become more popular.
Whoa. Life of Pi, the genre of an Indian guy alone on a boat, but also there's a tiger. That's a genre, isn't it?
And the glowing fish. Oh, as we all remember from the Ray Bradbury stories of glowy fish Tigerman. Listen.
Yes.
I think we could all agree that probably the highest quality genre film that either of us saw this year was Looper, right?
Oh my God, yes. A billion. But that means, wait, liked more or highest quality?
The one that you think will stand the test of time.
Yes, Looper was amazing. It was, I would say, the Avengers was more fun, and Dark Knight certainly felt bigger, but Looper, a billion years from now, archaeologists will find and be like, that's a damn fine time travel movie.
All right, so let's list off the 10 that are there. Lincoln, Zero Dark Thirty, Argo, Les Miserables, Life of Pi, Silver Linings Playbook, Amour, and Django Unchained. Of those, which have you seen?
None.
You didn't see Argo?
No.
Didn't you see Django?
No. We had a baby, though.
It's a worthless segment.
You didn't see Life of Pi. I saw Life of Pi, at least.
You did?
Yeah.
So then you have seen one.
Did you say Life of Pi?
Yes.
I don't remember that.
Would you put Looper in instead of Life of Pi?
Yeah, hells yeah, dude. I would slit the throat of Life of Pi. I'd let it bleed out, and then I'd go back in time and kill its corpse before it was even made.
All right. Let's say that this was not a fraud category like it is now with 10 nominations, but rather with 5.
Okay.
Do you think Looper survives a cut to 5? Is it in your top 5 movies of the year?
Yes. Yes. Done.
Well... then we don't really have a segment.
Well, okay, hold on. because we just agree in this all the way. Okay, here, let's kick it off again.
Here's the segment. Looper. Remember that movie from 6 months ago? Was it good? Yes. Back to you, Scott.
But we could just riff on reasons that it's better. Let's do it. Okay, first of all, we're 3 times over our limit already. We're supposed to go 60 and 90 seconds. So let's do this. Here, I'm going to stop it.
Well, because here was my thought. Press record again. My thought was, is it better than any of the movies that we've seen? Like, for me, I've seen Argo and I've seen Django Unchained.
Mm-hmm.
Would I replace either of those movies with Looper? And I would say no to Django and yes to Argo.
Yes.
And then it would be like, all right.
Well, and then could we just trash all the other movies? Like, would, like, just say.
I mean, that's easy, right? It's easy to trash the foreign film that nobody's seen.
Yeah. Maybe we'll say.
Like, that, yes. What? Yes. Exactly. The retarded kid gets pushed over really easily.
I'm like a Sota Balocha. Come on, man. Let's do that. All right, here's the problem. We only have 90 seconds, so we just gotta go fast. Let's do this bit as fast as we can and see how it comes out. Ready?
Well, all right.
Ready? And I'll say my name. You say your name. I'll say my name. I'll say we got 90 seconds. Go. And then, like, we're putting 90 seconds out of the clock, and then we'll just go back and forth and make our point as fast as we can. And then I will.
What's our point again?
We'll figure it out. Our point, our theme is Looper belongs on this list, and we talk about the various movies that it's better than, and maybe go on a tangent or whatever. But what I will do is every 30 seconds, I'll say, you know, 60 seconds left, and then I'll say 30 seconds left. And then we'll just wrap it up. Like, you know, like we got a movie minute that we're doing. You got it?
All right.
And go.
I'm Justin Robert Young.
I'm Brian Brushwood. You got 90 seconds. Go.
Looper was not among the 10 Best Picture nominees, and I believe that's a pile of crap that time traveled to merge with another pile of crap.
Yeah. Has a time travel movie ever even made a Best Picture nomination in the history of the world?
How about Back to the Future?
Was that a Best Picture?
I don't know.
It should have been. Let's make our own Oscar list of movies that should have been.
Time travel movies, yes. That have come back in time to, yes, 2013 or forward in time.
We only have 60 seconds. 60 seconds. I'm going to throw one in here, right? Primer. Primer should have been a Best Picture nominee because, granted, nobody could understand it. Nobody knew what was happening, but it had a totally unique time travel dynamic that nobody had ever seen before, and it was made for $20 and a taco. Go.
The Harry Potter movie where they go back to save that griffin. Spoiler alert. It's not, it had a griffin.
It's not true. You're thinking of the plot to Star Trek IV, The Search for Spock. Oh, wait, no.
No.
The
whale. You don't mind it, but they got a little thing. That's why Hermione's been like cracking out, doing meth, going to all those classes, because she's using time travel.
You only got 25 seconds left, and
you're,
I said the wrong one.
You're not down on the Harry Potter time travel?
If he did, that would be great. I'd love to see a fish out. Yeah. He could go to the future and fight robots.
Movie? Ain't you seen that movie, Brian?
do wands work against robots? Like, is there a technology rule?
Looper.
We're out of time. It's fucking gold. In the bank.
We did it as we could.
Congratulations. All right, I'm going to call out Ben Franklin right now. You need to write better material. Fuck you, Brian, is no longer doing it for me. Like, random hostility from my hero is getting less funny every time you do it. So this is your yellow card, Ben Franklin.
Well, I mean, that was awesome. Did you ever see that, Harry Potter?
Where we all dropped mushrooms and it was in my mind?
No, that's the plot of the third Harry Potter.
I thought you meant like... I thought you were intentionally riffing on. Let me save this. I'm gonna save this under. Wait, how far did they time travel in?
It's in. All right, so the big reveal, spoiler alert, is that.
Hermione's been taking double classes.
Yes, because she's been time traveling.
Right.
Yeah. And so they use, basically, there's like this whole Deus Ex Machina ending. Where, like, everything fucking wrong happens, and then Hermione's like, LOL, I can time travel. And then they do.
BT Dubs might have been good for me to tell you.
Earlier. But there's all these, like, little fucking, like, touches that are well done in both the book and the movie.
Okay, hold on. Take one.
And Windows Man is correct. They only travel back an hour.
Well, that's why I was confused, because, like, if it was going to be a substantial, I mean, that, I guess time travel is kind of a minor sub element in there. Wait.
Yeah, and that was the Guillermo del Toro Harry Potter movie.
All right, you want to do another take on it?
And I hope he showed it during his Qualcomm keynote.
It was a hell of a keynote. Hell of a keynote.
I feel like we could do something. We could get a better topic that we could actually kind of yell at each other about.
Wait, I mean, is it better if we're arguing? I guess so.
I think so. What is everybody all hot about? What do you think about that Pacific Rim trailer with the GLaDOS voice?
Fucking awesome.
All right. Well, we're not going to argue about that.
Okay. What about the GLaDOS thing being a cheesy gimmick versus or fan service?
Well, all right. How about this? Bullshit or no, Guillermo del Toro saying that the GLaDOS voice is not going to be in the actual movie. He literally just did it in the trailer to get attention for the fact that it was the GLaDOS voice because he likes Portal.
Did he say that?
He said it's the girl.
Yeah.
But like the GLaDOS filter is like turned to 10 in the trailer. And in the movie, he said it barely sounds like GLaDOS.
Oh, that is a dick move then.
Dick move or not?
Yeah, no, that's a dick move.
All right, here we go.
All right. Blur, 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 blur. If it's true, total dick move. All right?
Oh, here. We can pull up the actual quote.
Let's see. Guillermo del Toro, GLaDOS.
Here we go. I wanted to very much have her because I'm a big Portal fan, but it's just a wink. She's not cake obsessed. She's not out to destroy humanity. I said, look, there's no AI. I'd rather have GLaDOS. The filter we're using in the film is slightly less GLaDOS, slightly. The one in the trailer, I wanted to be full on GLaDOS. So not totally not.
Okay. Well, then, well, yeah. So it's not that bad. Like I could agree with dialing it up, but like selling an element that's not in there. Because I didn't get the impression that they were selling that at all.
Well, god damn it.
We almost had it. Oh, Evil Dead remake. Good idea, bad idea.
I mean, I don't know. I mean, you know my take on remakes. I mean, I guess if you want to take the side of bad idea.
Yeah, I don't know.
Like my remake, I'm an absolutist on remakes. All of them, always. In as many forms as possible.
Yeah, I. I mean, specifically, I didn't like. I didn't like what they did with this, or I didn't like the execution on the Spider-Man one. But I wasn't opposed. I went in expecting to like it and ready to like it. What do we disagree about? Pacific Rim, man. It's amazing. What?
Walking Dead? Are you excited for Walking Dead coming back? There's a new Walking Dead promo pictures of...
An eye for an eye. Remember the governor where he used to have two eyes? Now he has one eye, like the comics. Start jerking off, fanboy.
It's where we get. Are we gonna? I don't know where we disagree. But
I think we're both on the
that.
Same page with The Walking Dead. We used to disagree on The Walking Dead, and now we're. You want? I mean, the one thing that I thought was very interesting, though, is when we were talking about on the phone, Walking
Holy
Dead
shit.
Versus
Somebody in the
Game
chat
of
room.
Thrones.
Somebody just said, what is the appeal of Pacific Rim? Did, like, giant fucking robots?
I don't know. Yeah.
Right.
But we were talking about Walking Dead, on whether or not Walking Dead and Game of Thrones were of equal values in their own universes, like in the universe of comics.
Yes.
Whether Walking Dead is on the same par as Game of Thrones in the realm of fantasy literature.
Yeah.
And I think we definitely disagreed on that because you thought that they were of comparable quality in their own universes.
Yes, but it depended on how you define universes, because I said you don't get to put Walking Dead in the category of comic books and Game of Thrones in the category of fantasy, because that would be the equivalent of saying Walking Dead is not the best comic book, but to make it fair, you'd have to say Game of Thrones is not the best book. Like you can't pick a medium for one and a category for the other. You'd have to say zombie fiction for Walking Dead, and Walking Dead is
all zombie fiction, like even non-comic book zombie fiction.
Well, I don't know about that. If you're gonna play that, then you got to put Game of Thrones up against all fantasy television shows, movies, Dungeons and Dragons modules, all that shit. And it's like,
I'll do that. I'll take that any old day of the week.
What? You think Game of Thrones is Game of Thrones as on HBO? Is the best fantasy?
The books.
Okay. Do you think the books
We were talking about source material because
So you would say open call to all fantasy anyone's with an axe to grind. You will say Game of Thrones is the best fantasy. What other fantasy have you read?
Well, I mean, all right. The argument was that. And part of it is beyond what my particular opinion is, but that if there were an ability to rank these things critically, right? That I believed that in whatever universe, a fair universe that we were to agree upon, where they could accurately be judged amongst their peers, that Game of Thrones is head and shoulders better as source material than The Walking Dead.
Yes, but I said you have to grade on a curve within their category, within their wheelhouse. Within their wheelhouse, I do agree that Walking Dead is as important in the world of, you know, zombie comic book fiction as Game of Thrones is in fantasy written literature.
So, what was your universe for Walking Dead again?
Zombie comics for Walking Dead, fantasy books for Game of Thrones. And I would absolutely put them at equal importance.
But that's, I mean, like, such a smaller sample size, though, right?
Look, well, it's the fairest comparison. It's the fairest.
Is it?
Okay. What would be more fair?
I mean, I just kind of feel like.
How big should the circle be widened to make it feel more fair?
I mean, I can't even name another zombie comic series of note.
I mean, that's all right. I can only name like Lord of the Rings and Harry Potter on fantasy. But I know there's a lot out there.
Yeah, I mean, there's all the fucking what's this dude? The
Patrick Rothfuss, who is definitely our friend on the show.
No, who's the sort of Shannara or whatever?
Sure.
That guy. Narnia.
Yeah. Narnia, there's Blarnia. There's Harmonia.
Terry Brooks, that's who I'm thinking of.
Yeah.
I feel like if we were better read, this would be an epic fucking argument, and I think it would probably be we can't distill it to 90 seconds.
No way. Correct.
But I feel like if either of us can both come up with the vocabulary to accurately put it down, like, I think it could be something that we could really talk about. And really, it's just such an overlong way of saying that I think Game of Thrones is an extraordinary achievement, and Walking Dead is good, but oftentimes very frustrating and not fantastic.
Hoopy Hobo Hobbit. Wants to know,
do you want to go see The Hobbit? Have you seen The Hobbit?
No, I have no interest. I can't believe I'm saying
no interest?
That. I can't believe I'm saying that. I got no interest.
All right. Boom. All right. Got it. I'm going to sell you on The Hobbit.
All right. Here we go. Let me hit record. All right. Go.
I'm Justin Robert Young.
I'm Brian Brushwood. You got 39. Wait. Hold on. Say it again. Break. you got 39 seconds. All right. Go.
I'm Justin Robert Young.
I'm Brian Brushwood. Hold on. You had a Skype hitch.
I'm Justin Robert Young.
I'm Brian Brushwood. You got 90 seconds. Go.
You want to go see The Hobbit?
No.
Why?
I hate furry feet. It's not hygienic to walk around with those bare feet. And I had my fill. I'll tell you what, man. I enjoyed Lord of the Rings, but after seeing the whole thing, I don't ever feel the need to go watch them all again. You got 50 seconds.
Okay. Number one, you're racist. Number two, come back to this world, baby. Not, I need you to go see the movie for this reason. Nobody does fantasy action like Peter Jackson. It's not as good as Lord of the Rings, but it is something for which we just don't see. And when you go back there, you will be dispelled of the myth that you think you've seen your fill of this kind of filmmaking, because it's so big, it's such an achievement, all right, and it's so much fun.
All right, all right. 25 seconds. Explain the HFR. Why should I care?
Yes, it looks hyper-realistic, but it looks hyper-realistic where a man's standing next to a dragon, and that's an awesome scene.
Yeah, okay, but do you believe the dragon? Like, or
yes,
does it just...
Yes.
Really?
You believe the dragons, you believe the mines, you believe the goblins. That's why it's awesome.
What if I just go watch Looper again? Can I do that?
Then you can take a pooper on your chest, because that's right. A bad idea.
I'm going to go watch The Hobbit.
Go.
I'll save that.
I think that was the biggest thing, though, is that because I didn't think that I would miss seeing Lord of the Rings. Like, I thought, like, yeah, that was a cool thing for what it is. Then you watch The Hobbit and you're like, hey, it's like seeing an old friend. And you're like, oh, remember he does the thing and he has that catchphrase. Ah, old friend.
Yeah, that's fair enough. Man, do we want to go back to revisit The Dark Knight versus the Avengers?
I feel like it's kind of old pussy at this point.
It is. What's new pussy? What's there to...
I mean, new pussy would be what's coming out. Like, Superman. Excited?
Nope. Superman Returns ruined it for me. Just ruined Superman for me.
But why would... All right, let's go. You ready? You want to cue this out? We're going to bang out a month's worth of
these. All right, no, let's... And everyone's going to be, hey, Brian, you want to see it? No. No, I don't.
Here we go. You ready?
All right.
Hey, Brian. New posters for Superman Returns. You excited?
No.
Oh, wait. Fuck me.
Yeah, no, you might as well say that this is took Man place 6 years ago. All right.
All right. I'm Justin Robert Young.
I'm Brian Brushwood. You got 90 seconds. Go.
New posters for Man of Steel. You excited? Want to go see it?
Nope. No, why? I'm not. Because Superman Returns ruined it for me. This mopey creeper peeking in windows, getting shot in the eye with bullets, little half a Jesus guy. It's I'm
Why
done.
Would you hold Bryan Singer's homoerotic fan fiction against what is a completely new creative team? The script was worked on by Nolan himself, the godfather of the godfather films of comic book movies, the Dark Knight trilogy.
Now keep in mind, the question wasn't whether I'll go see it. The question was whether I'm excited about it. And
yes,
I'm just
like, why should those sins be held against it?
Because it's got stink. He's got crypto.
Superman's
poop.
Got stink.
He's got stank all up on it, and he's radiating his green Krypton poo. And I'm just like, I don't like that flavor right now. It's like, give me more of the Avengers. Just I want to go live in Marvel Land. And then now you come with your Sonic
until
boom.
There's one bad Marvel movie, and then you're like, I'm done. I'm done with that. Even though there's all new directors and actors and writers.
That is 100% right and accurate. And we're out of time.
poop. Now, if you want to hold something against it, you should hold Sucker Punch against it, because that is a movie that the director who's making that movie actually did that actually sucked.
Yeah. However, the cinematography was gorgeous.
Apparently, we're picnicking.
Huh? I'm fine, thank you. No picnic. So weird. Some people, like, there was a picnic contingency that just broke away.
Yeah, I know it wasn't a Time Warner picnic because I was here the whole time.
Yeah, yeah, you and I were both talking. All right, you want to try another one? Something, maybe something I am excited about. What are you not excited about that's coming up?
I don't know, man. I'm kind of easy. Like, and probably the only, like, the last thing that I was, like, super, like, this is going to blow was, like, Cloud Atlas. And that was awesome.
Oh, you liked Cloud Atlas?
Oh, yeah. No,
After shitting on it? That's awesome.
Well, no, I shit on the fact that it was going to make money.
Right. No, and you were right to do so. You were right to do so. Did you watch Blood and Chrome over on the Machinima?
No, I didn't.
I watched the first episode with Brant, and then got halfway through the second episode, and then realized, like, he never watched all of the original series or of the Ronald D. Moore Battlestar Galactica, yeah. And I was like, this is not right. So I stopped it, and I went back and I rewatched 33 with Brant, like, and I think I made the right decision.
Have you seen the Portlandia episode with Battlestar Galactica?
Is that the one where they keep saying just one more episode?
Yeah.
Yes. Okay. Because I remember the skit, but I didn't remember what the show was that they were watching.
Did you? So, but you saw it to the end of it?
Yeah. What was the payoff on that at the end?
Well, they find somebody named Ronald D. Moore in the phone book.
Yeah.
And they go convince him to write another episode of Battlestar Galactica.
Oh, that's awesome.
If you haven't seen that, then I beg you to watch the episode, because okay, then there is a sketch after that.
Maybe I'm thinking of a different episode then. Maybe it was like
No. That's the first sketch is them.
Okay, I've only seen the first sketch is what
yeah,
it is.
Yeah, no. To watch that episode, because there's a very funny payoff to that.
Okay. We just want to send them these three options.
Man, I feel like we're getting close. We just need. I feel like if we had one more, just one more episode, Brian.
Yeah, no, I'm down with that. I'm cool. Why don't we fight about which was better of greatest hits? I like there being a vaguely
who's excited.
No, like a vaguely Oscar related thing. It seems like there's something we could do with Oscars.
What's the last? I don't know. I love that also people have no idea what we're doing. Although, fucking, how about the guy and the place and the.
Oh
the
my thing? God! Fucking detectives! Finding that shit out. It was like the over under was like 15 minutes. That shit was out, and they're like, so this is the guy, the place, and the thing. And I'm like, motherfucker, this is good. And it's like, you go back and you listen to your fucking epic rant.
Wow. Am I never gonna work with a region 3?
You will never be at the place. If the place ever figures out what's going on.
Nope. Oh, bridge burner young, they call us. I hope they I mean, I don't know whether they have edited the second episode that I was on, but I remember that being very, very funny.
You show up in this episode. You're in it.
Oh, I do?
At the very end in the preview. Here, you want to see yourself?
Oh, sure, yeah.
Yeah, here you go.
So they just slapped the whole thing that they had given to Revision 3.
No, we rose of shit.
Scary grown-up thoughts have shriveled this guy.
Obviously.
Just saying, it's some guys in a
I'd said Revision 3 before.
It's more fun if we don't know.
The place.
Well, they split it into two episodes here, and they I know they've edited the second one.
He's not even doing it. Only is standing on the shoulders of certain fantastic
American Horror.
Well, see you guys next week.
So we got to start this off. Come on.
Yeah.
Coffee and beer flash. It's our second episode. Justin Robert Young.
Glad to be here. At 10
glad you're here.
Huzzah. I like that you guys, like, we just kept rolling into the diner. You're like, oh, a little bit of coffee. We're like, hello. Two beers. Nah.
Domain.com.
That was your big film riot moment.
Boom. There we go.
Was it everything you hoped for, sir?
Well, it's the first and last time I'll ever appear.
No, it's not the first time.
No, you're right.
You've been on, you love Laserdiscs.
I guess that they're going to do... I guess that they're saying that it's like two halves.
Well, no. This is the second week. They showed the first half last week, and today's Thursday, which means new film riot. And they posted this was the second half.
Okay.
And that was the last few seconds of the second half.
Have you?
And here, let me see.
So is this like, would this be like a backdoor pilot? Like if people are demanding, hey, more?
Well, I
probably not. I mean, like, it's like he has too many goddamn things to do.
Well, I'll tell you what, though. Look at these fucking responses. Like 169 yays, 3 no thank yous. But then
what are people saying in the comments? Like, this is the best. My favorite part was the guy at the end.
they're just all. Oh, man. I agree. This was recorded pre-avenging. No exaggeration. Watchmen is the single worst movie I've ever seen in my entire life.
You know what my favorite part about the Watchmen was? When they just started saying lines from the comic. I'm like, yay, I remember that comic. I like it.
Well, that's what they say. They say, boy, look at this. Does this tell you anything? Like, half the comments were like, Tim Allen ran your camera? Huh, how'd you afford him? And,
Wow. Like, come a long way, baby.
Well, yeah, like they just clearly had never even seen the early episodes.
I actually really like watching this.
I think everyone seemed very surprised about how much they liked a long form, slickly shot show.
Well, I think that's like kind of what it is. Like, you know, if you have an audience on YouTube that is like into whatever you do, if they're willing to watch you, like, you know, go over how you like to brush your teeth, then like, yeah, long form content works. Like, what doesn't work is like when we try to do stuff with Twit, where it's like, hey, let's put a long form thing with people you don't know.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah. Yeah, that is a good point for people saying the Avengers is the best superhero movie. Was that over a year ago that we shot that? No, it was February of last year.
No, it was during football season because I remember there was a Steelers game. It was a Monday night, and there was a Steelers game on that I wasn't watching. I was sacrificing for the boys.
But this was when I was in Florida for some...
No, you flew down specifically, I think. Oh, no. You were there. It was during October.
October. Because
you were there for the Halloween stuff at the casino.
That's when it was. Okay, so it was over a year ago.
Oh, yeah, no, big time.
Huh.
Ashley was there, too.
Wow. That's crazy.
That was the first time that Ashley met the Film Riot guys.
Wow. Yeah, that's right. How did that go crazy?
I mean, yeah, no, that's been sitting out for a while.
Yeah, I'm glad they put
then
it
again,
out
that was also before they moved to Texas and...
Oh, shit, yeah, they've been in Texas for almost a year now, too.
Yeah.
Ben Franklin quite wisely points out that The Big Lebowski doesn't really get funny until you've seen it like four times. And that's 100% true. Like, you've got to... No, well, I mean, it certainly gets funnier each time those first four times. Like, you, as you get farther from the distraction of caring about the plot, it gets better and better.
I mean, I agree with you under this premise that now when we are talking about The Big Lebowski in underlined italics, the thing that has people go and like has little mini cons at bowling alleys every year and people like quote like it's the Bible. Yes. Like you might watch it and say, but this is just a film made by Mia Men. And it might take a while for you to get through that haze. But as a movie, legit. It is for me, the hardest I ever laughed at The Big Lebowski was the first time I saw it.
Yeah. Oh my God, look at this comment. Right there. My favorite part was the guy at the end. That's amazing.
Man, it'd be really crazy if the number one comment was, oh my God, was that Justin Robert Young? Release the second episode.
Okay, let's make that happen right now. Somebody pop that up and you log in yourself, Justin. let's sneak attack that shit right now. A little day attack. Here we go. I'll pop a link in there. Somebody pop a quote in there. OMG, Justin Robert Young. Okay, you full quote has to be, OMG, Justin Robert Young, release the second episode immediately. We'll wait for it. Wait for it. Wait for it. Pressing refresh. Buried alive. Alive.
All right, where's that link? You put the link in the chat.
The funny guy at the end, you can't tell. You don't know for sure if that if it's just here. I'll say yes to both those though. There we go, right there. Cowgirl Curtis, because we got a picture of cute girl too. Boom. M1 Rock CGCs.
Oh wow, that was easy to get to the number one comment.
Oh, is it? Wow. Yeah, it is up there. Amazing. I'm going to keep clicking vote up.
OMG, Justin Robert. Yeah.
Holy crap, look at that. We got 20 already. No way, was that Justin Robert Young? Released the second episode. It's pretty amazing the way that shit can be guided.
I mean, again, we've had conversations with people who have made careers in selling things for a living.
Yeah.
And all of them are uniformly amazing, or amazed by ChatRealm's agility.
Yes.
That it's just like we say one thing and the entire school of fish turns.
Well, it's that flocking algorithm, right? Where it's just like we just all operate perfectly in synchronization.
All right, so what we're doing is upvoting the completely retarded assertion that for the 5 seconds that I'm in the end of the new film, right, that it's a clamoring demand that they release the second episode, for which I'm actually on. There is a second episode where me, Brian,
here, I'll show it again. And
Todd, right? Is it Todd Bruno?
Yes, it is. Oh, by the way, Patrick Delahanty points out that's an awesome shirt he's rocking.
Because it was Patrick's shirt, yeah.
Yeah, physically made by the hands of one Justin Robert Rubles. Or one Patrick Delahanty. Here we go.
So we got
right there.
Yeah. And my hair looks great, by the way.
Sorry, our second episode, Justin Robert Young.
Glad to be here at 10 a.m.
Huzzah.
Wow, man. This is amazing to watch. Look at that number one. With a bullet. That's amazing.
I love that it's as if I've never been on Film Riot episodes before.
Right. All right. Well, I guess I'll send over these three things that we did. You can pick something.
Fuck, man. All right. Quick fire. What are you pissed off about right now? Genre stuff. Like, what have you talked about on frame rate, like, in terms of things? How about that Why the Last Man thing? I guess we're not really going to argue about it, but it's your boy, Danny.
Yeah. No. Yeah, dude. I'll tell you what. I'm super stoked. He's somebody who respects the source material. He gets it.
I want you to shit on your friend. I want you to take the content. I think Dragonberg's going to do a great Why the Last Man. Nope. Not excited to see it.
If you want to, I'd love for Dan to tell the story, but I'll tell the story to the chat room watcher right now. It was at Dragon Con that I got a message from Dan Trachtenberg that says, I forgot if it just said like call me or something, but basically he's just like, hey, I've got a thing that I would love to hear your thoughts on. And the way he pitched it to me was that he said, you know, what would it look? He said, what I'd love to see that nobody's done yet is really involve more of Yorick's skills as a magician to get out of sticky situations in Why the Last Man. And he's like, what would you like to see that would be magic related? What if Indiana Jones had the skills of a Houdini? What would you like to see him do? And we brainstormed some stuff, and I'm sure he doesn't want me talking about what the sequence was, but we combined like three things and we came up with a sequence.
But you can confirm that part of the pitch process was something that you helped him develop in terms of the action beat.
Yes. Yes. And he liked the way it flowed, and then he wrote me an email later on saying, dude, they loved this sequence, they loved the pitch, they, you know, I feel really good about this, blah blah blah, and he's like, well, you know, if we do, I'd love to continue to pick your brain on some magic related stuff. I'm like, oh man, it'd be a freaking dream, are you kidding me? And then he says, just one thing. And I'm like, what? And he's like, if I get this gig, you must explain to me how that book trick works. And I'm like, yeah, sure, dude. You get this gig, I'll explain the whole book test to you. It's and you know what?
You're like rolling the dice. Yeah, I mean, yeah, it's totally Hollywood. Right. That's a gigantic property. That's a property that, just so everybody knows, has been attached to DJ Caruso,
mm-hmm.
who did Eagle Eye and Suburbia, was a very the Die Hard movie DJ Caruso did, mm-hmm. And Louis Leterrier, who did the Incredible Hulk remake.
Holy cow, yeah.
Is doing the new movie about the magician bank robbers.
Yes. Wow.
Those are the directors that have been attached to this movie. And now it's
Dan Trachtenberg. But the best part is, like, we had some exchange, like, 2 months later, he says, by the way, you might have to explain to me how that book trick's done. And I'm like, shut up, really? He's like, you might have to do it. I was like, all right. And then it was like 5 days ago that finally I was like, so it's confirmed? And he's like, yep. And I'm like, all right, let me Skype you. And I spent like 30 minutes walking him through the entire thing. And he's like, That's funny. Is unbelievable. That's amazing. And then I asked, like, what's funny is, like, he told me not to talk to anyone, so I didn't even tell my wife. And so finally, I was playing coy. I'm like, can I tell Bonnie? He's like, oh yeah, no, you could talk to your friends. You know, just don't publish anything yet. Cause it's like, it was that much in the bag by that point that it wasn't, you know, it was kind of an open secret at that point, I guess, but I didn't know.
And it's also, I mean, it's Hollywood.
Yes.
Like, you know, everything can go. And by the way, this can be, it would not be abnormal if this is the last we ever hear of Danny Trek publicly.
Yes.
Of Danny Trachtenberg and Why the Last Man. Like, that's just how fucked up and weird Hollywood and movies are, that all, yes, of a sudden something goes into turnaround and next thing it's done or whatever.
Right.
But it's awesome that he's listed with it and he's in there. I think he'll do a great job on the movie, you know, if and when it happens. And hopefully, magic consultant.
Oh, Ryan, dude, are you kidding me? That would be a fucking dream. It's like I want to go out of my way to be so useful that that he can't help but not, you know, just be like, you know, sure, you don't want to come out and be on set to help out with something, you know? And it's like, oh my god,
push for magic consultant. And when I say that, I mean push for Justin gets to visit the set of Why the Last Man the movie.
It would be amazing. It would be amazing. And
I mean, and this is something, it's funny because you've always kept me in the loop on like your interactions with him, because that was like, I sent you all the copies for Why the Last, because I was such a big fan of it that I sent absolutely. You the copies for it.
Yeah. Like I read the first 20 something issues on my first flight out to Indonesia. And when I came back, you sent me a giant brick of all the rest of them. So it was, yeah, man. It was good.
And for those asking, Yorick, the main character in Why the last man alive on Earth, at the beginning of our story, is a escape artist, amateur magician.
Yes.
And there are cues and touches in the movie on, you know, referring to that. But it's such a sprawling story. I would love it if, you know, we were not resolved with our big mystery by the end of it, you know.
Leaving it open for another. Dude, do you know what Skype just told me? Today is, as of this minute, I guess it's all day, today's Travis Lopes' birthday.
Whoa.
We need
the original, the OG. Yes. The Mixmaster.
The OTL.
Mike.
Jet Li.
For the BB Live Show.
Jet Li 3. Let me send a little thing at Travis Lopes.
I mean, I'll just say this. I don't know if the chat room as it is currently constituted exists without Travis Lopes.
Absolutely.
Because there was a point where, like, the behavior for which me and Brian exhibit, which by which I mean is extraordinarily lazy, and as us just saying, thing! Happy.
We have vision. Vision should be thing show.
The first guy to take that seriously was Travis Lopes.
Yep.
And if it weren't for him, we would be doing things like trying to make this shit ourselves and failing and getting frustrated and stopping making it.
Well, it was okay. The OGs were Travis Lopes, Patrick Delahanty, T2T2, and Vincent 404. And of course, you know, friends I had that predated the live stream, like, you know, Lonely.Geek, you know, DJ Z beforehand.
Oh, yeah. No, all of them, everybody that you just mentioned, and many still with us, obviously, you know, including here in the chat room.
Yes.
In Pete Delahanty's case. But
they're hardcore. They're DC till they DIE.
DC before there was a DC.
That's right.
Pre-DC.
Yeah. They're what defined the DC. They're why we decided to call
absolutely.
It.
Absolutely.
Yes. or as Pretty Jumble says, many with us, many have died in fires.
But Travis Lopes, I mean, he was the one that that really made so much of it possible. We owe Travis Lopes a great, great, great debt.
Yeah.
People are asking what the wine. Ash, what is this wine? Apothic Red is what I'm drinking.
All right, look, man, I gotta
I think we're done, right?
Yeah.
We can't think of anything else.
No, I cannot. What I can think of. Have you played this game? Have you seen this game?
Journey? No. By the way, guess who now has a functioning Xbox in this apartment?
Okay, we already went over the platonic nature of your friend. dude, do you have an Xbox Pro account?
No, we don't. And that was actually a point of discussion, because I'm like, oh, well, we have an Xbox in the living room. We can just move the Apple TV. Actually, we wanted to leave the Apple TV in the living room, so that way we could like airplay.
Yep.
But I'm like, oh, we can just watch Netflix off the Xbox. And yeah. Then I realized that you have to like pay before you pay for Netflix on the Xbox.
I'll tell you what, though. It's like, it's just this one time a year Band-Aid you got to rip off. And it's like, there's a lot that's pretty cool about it.
Yeah, I mean, like, if I get into playing stuff in multiplayer, like, I mean, like, I almost did it when we were just talking about it. And then I'm like, well, I'm really paying money for not something that currently I'm not going to use. But if I ever like really got into something, I could find myself very easily talking myself into spending $60.
Yeah, man. Tell you what, it's worth doing just to play Settlers of Catan online with other people. Have you ever played Settlers of Catan?
No, you know who's fucking obsessed with Settlers of Catan is Brett, the Amtrak of Roundsville.
It's
his boys. They like fucking play on the iPad with each other constantly.
I'll tell you what, the iPad app is shit compared to the Xbox version. The Xbox version of Catan is superior to all others, and I'm including the actual board game in that, because it looks gorgeous. It forces you, because you only have 90 seconds to play, it forces you not to goof around. Negotiations are fast, and there's just enough impersonality to it that you don't get like angry the way you do at the actual board game, where you're like, why won't you give me that wood? You're just fucking, you're giving him the game.
So wait, that journey, this video you're playing now, this game has been out for a while, right?
Yeah. It, in fact, we covered it on Game On.
That's how I remember it. All of my video game knowledge comes from writing Game On. I don't play attention to video games unless I'm getting
paid like for there's it. Like this 3-month window when you're intimately familiar with this with all the goings on in the game.
Well, here's
how
much of a fucking bullshit artist I am: is that like I got paid to write about video games for 3 months, and now any video game topic that anybody brings up, I will find a way to bring it back to that 3 months.
Oh,
so
dude.
I can seem like I have fucking any kind of relevancy at
all. That's exactly what I do. And if you can't, then you switch over to question asking mode and you figure out a way to be like, now how would this compare to something like Journey?
Yes. Oh no, that I do that. And also I was talking with Ashley before that, my go-to, you will know that I don't know what the fuck you're talking about, but I want to continue the conversation. If I ever, like, whenever, like, here, talk about something in a video game that I don't know. About, like, a video game you're, like, playing that
I'll tell you what I'm sincerely enjoying right now is, it's King's Bounty, Warriors of the North. It's like this.
Yeah, of course.
Oh, are you familiar with it?
Of course.
Really? Which,
No. See, that's the thing. Is I'll just throw in, yeah, of course. And you'll be, like, so excited that I know what you're talking about, and really 90% of all conversation is just people talking about things that they want to talk about and not wanting to actually have a conversation.
Yes.
So they just take that as validation and just keep going. Like, that's just their ticket to ride. They're like, oh, you're interested? Here's my continued conversation on this.
I'm begging.
Oh, I have to get the
glue. All right, here. All right, I have our last 90 minutes silly conversation.
All right, 90 minutes?
Or 90 seconds. Yes, we're doing another 90 minutes, Brian.
All right. Thank goodness. All right, here, let me press this, and then I'll switch back to this.
Wait, are you playing that?
Yeah.
Oh, I thought you were just playing a video.
No, that was me playing it.
Oh, look at that.
Yeah.
Wait, you have a PlayStation?
I do now. That's fucking Rob Krekel hits me up. We were talking on Skype, and Rob's like, I would really, really like to see you play through Uncharted. And I was like, well, that'd be great if I had Uncharted or a PlayStation 3. And he's like,
he made a few calls?
Well, yeah. He was like, well, you know, I work at Sony. I'm like, yeah, you know, it's like, whatever. And then the next day he's like, sending you a package. And I was like, well, maybe it's a PS3 and Uncharted. And then when I opened the fucking package, it's a brand new PS3. It's the Journey Collector's Edition with Flower and Flow. The collection of Icos, Shadow of the Colossus, Heavy Rain, the Little Big Planet 2, a bright pink controller to go with my bright pink face, and then Uncharted 1, 2, and 3. So, God. Obviously, first thing I had to do was be like, you know, last thing I'm going to do is like, oh, no, I'll get around to hooking up the PS3. I'm like, fuck no, man. It's like, we're doing this today. And so I got it barely hooked up last night, but it looked like shit because I had to use the analog thing. But then I went and bought a component cable and have it hooked up to that. That's the reason that this is the only camera that's active right now, because this is plugged into the other one right there. But
well, fart on my balls.
Yeah, man. All right. It's like, in fact, I was actually hoping that we could.
Let's go.
Okay. Well, when we got time, like, I was actually hoping that we could play something and make commentary together, because I thought that would be hilarious.
No, definitely. I would love to do it.
Okay. Here we go. Let me.
And also, I want to make it clear that Rob Krenkel can send me any free shit. <he wants. laughs>
Yeah. Despite the fact that I just shat all over games and say I never play them, I would really like a PlayStation 3.
Yes. Well, no. What did I say, Brian? I'm interested when I get paid to talk about video games.
Fair enough.
I will accept free gifts from Sony as form of payment.
Fair
we
enough.
We all got the coin we work for.
All right.
Ass has its master.
Okay, you ready?
Yeah. I'm Justin Robert Young.
I'm Brian Brushwood. You got 90 seconds. Go.
Was the Bane voice really, really silly now that we've had time to digest it?
Weirdly, it's the opposite, man. It's like the whole movie long, I was like, this voice is stupid. It's all warped. I can't. What did he say again?
Silly, Brian.
Why can't he do it? And then it wasn't until like later that same day when I
found myself doing the Bane voice. That
now,
all of a sudden,
is it that we all can do the Bane voice and we enjoy doing it and that it's a fun voice to do?
I'm not sure. Why don't you explain it to me, Justin?
Because initially, when people first saw it, it was A, hard to understand, and B, sounded like Elmer Fudd. And we were all very, very upset by it, that in a very serious universe that Christopher Nolan had painted for the Batman, that this cartoon ridiculous voice was a part of it. Now, you saying it has been legitimized by time, not something that people 5 years from now will watch and be like, this is retarded.
he's like,
when you're able to do a good impression of my voice, then you have permission to love the Bane.
That's what it is, man. It's like
I agree, by the way. I am totally with you. I think that it is so iconic, it has no choice but to live in our memory forever.
Because we can do an impression of it.
You're right, Brian.
Yes. He's probably wondering why you're still doing bad impressions.
Why hasn't this segment ended?
Okay, it's over now. That's the one.
I say we send them all. We're done for the month.
Oh, yeah. Well, that's correct.
I'm Bane. That's my name. Ask me again, I'll tell you the same.
All right. Well, my computer's about to die, and I still got to hook up my Roku box.
Bye, man. Roku box. Hey, I'm going back on the road tomorrow. I have to go anyway. I have to go to the airport in the morning. How long has it been since you heard me say that?
Yeah, I'm actually about to go. I'm back. I'm back on the road next Tuesday morning.
Do we want to? Cowgirl Curtis wants to know what all this is for. Do we want to tell her? You'll find out in 2 days. How about that?
How about we build a little mystery?
Yeah. How about there's a thing? There's a guy.
How about this? Brian spilled the beans on like his inner workings on like massive fucking movie news today. How about that's enough? Like, because by the way, I wrote a thing on iTricks about Why the Last Man. And like, I've spoken to you about your involvement in the pitching process of Why the Last Man. And I'm like, well, I would like to write how much I actually know about the process of Danny Trachtenberg's involvement in this project and not write it like, oh my God, Danny Trachtenberg,
right,
the total
right.
Rat show. But I'm like, it's not my story. It's Brian's story. It's Danny's story. So I don't want, despite the fact that I know.
Right.
I don't want to breach that trust. Brian told you that story tonight. What I didn't want to write on the internet, that knowing full well that Brian would probably be cool about it, but I didn't want to breach that trust. Brian has gone.
And likewise, this is one of those where it's like, look, I don't mind you guys hearing it. I don't mind this showing up on the BBpedia videos, but I would not like to see this linked as major news leak behind the scenes at Why the Last Man or whatever.
All right.
TV's Egon, the movie news was that I guess it's not the only reason I felt comfortable saying this much now was because Dan publicly thanked me for helping out him with that today.
Yeah.
On Twitter. He said big thanks for Schwood for helping me out with that. So it's
So anyway. Okay. That was the behind the scenes on that. What we just recorded, literally, it's not going to take more than 72 hours for you to find out.
You'll figure it out very quickly.
It's going to be there. But we've already mentioned the first name of the person we're working with. And if you run down the list of people that we've worked with that first name, it's not a long list. So figure it out.
Yeah. Figure it out.
Cheers, kids.
Bye bye.
Bye.
You gotta upload this thing to Schwood.com.
Hold on, give me just 2 seconds here. Would you just for 1 second? My God, people, let me upload these videos. Bum bum. Boop 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 doo doo. Oops. And then I almost showed you stuff. It must be for frog pants. You would think, wouldn't you? All right, let me do this. I actually do need to call it because I do need to get up kind of like at 6 a.m. But 1, 2, 3, 4. Because we're fucking pros. There's that. Oh, Jacksonville, Florida. If you're in or around Jacksonville, Florida area tomorrow, why don't you come out and see my show? Here, I'm going to turn this thing on. Beep. Boo-deep. Beep, beep, beep-deep. Boo-deep. Beep, beep, beep-deep. Beep, boo-deep. Damn it, Brian Brushen. Why? What did I do? I'm always doing something wrong. ASU or U of A, where are those? Which ASU? Arkansas? Woo! Wow. Oh, Arizona? Yeah, no, I played one of those last year before. Wait, Jackie Hearn, are you near Jacksonville? Yeah, I leave tomorrow. I'm doing a teaser tomorrow in Jacksonville. This is a weird thing. This never happens, but they totally asked me to come in a day early to do teasers. Because I guess they just really want a good turnout for the show. But they paid me extra to come in a day early. So I'm going to get in, fly in, go straight to hit the dorms, start doing teasers, tell people all about the show, and just kind of hang out on a Friday night. So, I don't know, maybe meet up tomorrow night, Jacksonville? Or we can, you could come out to the show, and for seriousness, Miss Jackie Hearn, if you want to come out and come see the full stage show, it's at Campbell University. Is that a university? Let me look. I'm gonna have to look it up. Jacksonville, Southwest Airlines. Let's see. Halftime performance. Apparently I'm performing at a halftime performance for something tomorrow. I should really look at all this crap. Viewing this. It is at University of North Florida tomorrow. I leave there. University of North Florida, Jacksonville, Florida. Let's see. I'm doing teasers tomorrow. I'm doing teasers at the halftime show at 4:30 in the afternoon on Saturday. Then I'm doing a 7:30 p.m. performance. So 7:30 at the Robinson Theater. And that is it. Right? So that'll be fun. Go ahead. 866-EAT-FIRE. You can call my cell phone and I'll make sure that you get in. Or drop me a tweets or any of that. Oh, what a bummer, Mike Inn. It was a great time. It was a good group. The My Little Pony convention.
But I've got the power to flap my wings.
What? Nope, get back here. Give me your birds. All right, hold on. I just realized I'm looking at the tiny screen. I don't like that. There we go. I played the alpha for Hawken. I did not play the full free-to-play Hawken. I think I have to go up here. I think I have to ride these currents. No! I don't have jump power. I sincerely only have one power, and that's to jump. Maybe glide. They call me Glidey McJumples. Does this look like significantly crappier than when we had it on 720p? I'm convinced I'm supposed to jump on these. What do you suppose these posts are of? Like, all I could think of is like a decayed, desiccated remains of post-apocalyptic overpasses. Right. Yes, I am queen of the bouncy jumps. Keep going. Keep going. No! You gotta get up higher than that. Go to the StubHub. Get some tickets. What? What? What did I do? Whoa! So many birds. Come back. Give me your powers. Your stub hubs belong to me. All right. Let's do this. Go, go, go. I'll tell you one thing that's really smart about the design on this is all the things that they intentionally keep going. Oh, you suck. You should be ashamed of yourself. How can you make it across that? This is where my quest for the hill that is bigger than my hill ends. Come here, you ticket stubs. Thank you. Wait for it. I guess I have to go and do all those flag things over there. There's a glowing thing, there's a flag thing, there's another flag thing over there. Everyone thinks they're so great with their flapping flags and glowing things. Another glow thing over there. Attack the glow things! My power to jump must increase! Only through the power to jump really high can I succeed in my quest to go to the mountain that's bigger than my little hill. Yes. Yes. And now, my mad quest to be able to jump really high. I see you, mountain over there, thinking you're all great. Maybe you kind of are, all majestic with a big bright thing coming off. But soon I'll be able to jump even higher. Then where will your gods be? Will you demand a sacrifice? Come on, you can do it. Come on. Come on. Keep on going. You can do this. Yes, I believe in you.
and your power to walk slowly through even sand. Wait, perhaps there's still some magic in this old ribbon. No, there's not. Oh. If only I could jump up on that, that'd be really useful. I'm gonna have to go find ticket stubs. God damn it. I'll be right back. I gotta walk, because I used my jumpy juice. However, my ponytail's getting very long.
Very long ponytail.
Yes. Have I ever been to AUS? I assume you mean Australia, not Austin, because I live in Austin. Yeah, that's right. I gotta believe. Cowgirl Curtis is asking... Wait, which school was the last one? When was the last time I was in Atlanta but that wasn't Dragon Con?
Yes.
Give me your power. Yes, I set you free. Now, be my slaves, please. All of you? No? Dude, I love wondering what this world is. Like, is this an ancient civilization long dead, or? Yeah, who's skating? Me. How you like me now? Who's floating very high, I'll have you know. Oh no. Who used up her floaty powers? No! Don't! I cannot. Oh, wait. Can I jump if I go fast? Jump. Kind of? No. Jump. No. I must go to these ticket stubs. Going. You know you got to. You got to. Come on. Those floaty things aren't gonna glow themselves. Oh no. Up. Oh. Yes. I did a thing. And now I'll do another thing. I have set you free, as is your destiny, to do my bidding. Yes! Sota Belocha. Look, there I am. Oh, I never got an answer. Like, is the quality significantly reduced doing this 360 by 3 or 640? Or
is it like, was it better when it was 720p, or it's all the same crap?
I might be dodging a little bit of homework, including packing for this trip. I may have not packed for this trip. And instead, I may be playing this game for your amusement. Full screen looked better on the 720p, okay. Yeah, I'm sure if you're watching it in a window, it looks the same, just as good. Yes. Ooh, do a flip. Do a barrel. Yes. Oh!
Tombstones, tombstones, turn on the lights, disturb the dead. Do a little dance, move in a circle, wave your long scarf in my face. Get all up in the glow, steal the spotlight and the show.
Oh, great glowing tall one. You look very tall, like that mountain is very tall. You're the embodiment of tallness and glowiness. I want to be as you are. Take the L down to 4th Street. Go across to Cross Park Avenue. Turn on all the lights. Don't worry about it. Electricity is free in this world. This is actually the part I was playing to get to. No, not this one. The one after this is the place. Maybe this is the part. The place with the thing and the deal. Run on the walls. Look, I'm Prince of Persia. It's like an 8-year-old pretending she's doing something awesome. Look at me. Yes. I bet you have. Wait a minute, I'm not controlling this at all! Cinematic boo! Man, that mountain's even bigger and taller and glowinger in the distance. I don't know why, I just want it. Wait, is that like a comet? Let's do this. Surfing on the pink waves.
I want to do more surfing.
Under a green sky. Yeah, this is definitely an acid trip right here. Ooh, yes. Thing to activate. What? And now who's flying? I'm flying. That's right. Yeah, send me your tickets. What? Well, hello, you. What are you doing? Go away. Creep me out. Wait, come back. I didn't mean it. Hey! Hold on, you little scamp. You little tramp scamp. I'm gonna draw you on the back, right above my buttocks. Come back! Motherfucker. You think you're better than me? I have a long scarf. I could jump very high. And he's running off, you piece of shit. No one ever. He's gonna tease me? Yeah, fuck it. I don't have to. I can sit right here. That's right. You coming back? No? You gonna make me come get you? You sorry sack of. Oh my. Now I can surf. And jump. Man, got a bunch of your friends. Come on, guys. Everyone give me floaty juice. That would be great. Okay, it's a bit high, a little uncomfortable. Wait. Come on, somebody save me. Help me to continue to fly. I want to be flying with you. Please. Okay, good. Floating juice. Thank you.
Go. You can do it.
Float!
What? Don't you understand? There's a mountain over there that must be tamed as all mountains must. Hold on. What are you gonna attack me? Whoa. I'm on a quest to jump really high. Yeah. Come on, man. Let's go. Oh, that mountain's so far away, I'll never make it. I guess my journey ends here. Glowy thing on that ruin? Oh, there is a glowy thing in the ruin! Good eye. And my quest to become high jumper must be. What? Give me all your glow powers.
Sork, all my subroutines are yours to command.
No! No! So close. I'm a failure.
Why don't you guys help me? That'd be rad. Oh, I see what you want me to do. I know how game theory works. You want me to take some kind of sensible route? No.
Go, 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 go.
Bah. Boo. I don't know, I feel like I can almost make it from here. Is there a glowy thing on the last ruin? Can I call to you? Whoa! How did I do that? How did I call them? I sung a song and they danced for me. And my penis became even longer! Yeah, thank you. You were there when I needed a friend. All right, hold on. Oh, dang it. I actually have one. Never mind. Here. Padre SJ says something about the Rev 3 party and the guest impersonating Schwood. I don't see who the guest impersonating Schwood is. Stormage? This will complicate my journey. Thank you, my carpet friend. coming out. Hey, look at that. I did a thing. Turn on all the lights, touch all the graves. Waste all of the energy that you saved.
What? Go on, let's talk to Giant Tall Yoda.
I am the spirit of the very tall mountain. Let me remind you that you still have to take the L to the next stop, which will lead you to the land of these buildings. Wait, this is where you are, I just realized. I'm sorry, I'm not a very good guide. I thought I was telling you what was next. Instead, I'm telling you what is. Now you're going to these places where once there was corn. Giant dogs. Let's do this. What's up, my floaty bloaty friend? Take me on a magical journey. Let's all have a hug pile. Guys? Yeah, this is the moment of the game for me. This whole experience is rad. Dude, is that not, like, just transcendently beautiful?
This is the moment of the game. 100 years from now, when my cybernetic brain remembers playing this game in the 21st century, I'll remember this moment. Hey, bud. What's going on, Brent? You wanted to see it? You missed the gorgeous part. It is me, very tall, wise Yoda, who is the spirit of the taller mountain that you are jealous of. Lightning means this part will be easy and fun. And the fact that it looks technological means that it'll be a paradise. All right, if I'm saving, then I guess I gotta call it a night.
I gotta get up and I'm so pretty.
Try to imagine Rooker playing this. Man, what do you think of this business, Brant? You like that?
I don't know. I've never tried it. But I think as long as it's something that's kind of...
There. Wait. There, now go.
Yeah. Can you hear me now?
Yes.
Okay. Yeah, I think as long as it's kind of a control that's kind of tertiary, you know? It's not, like, super vital for what you're doing. Because, like, this seems like it would work well, but I've never tried it myself.
Yeah. I mean, I can imagine in certain situations.
Sure.
What am I looking at?
Also, high cover.
There we go.
This game is so pretty.
It really is. It's, I love that it doesn't pretend to be anything than what it is. A feeling-based experience. It's like, you know, it means whatever it means to you.
Yeah, sure.
are you guys hiding down here? Seems like you guys don't run away from me, motherfuckers. Pieces of shit. Am I supposed to follow you? Because you think you're better than me? Oh, that's right. All of this is meant to feel very underwatery. Went back to the beginning, son of a bitch. I think I did. Scream! Float! Use your floaty powers. Your giant pigtail penis. Ponytail. Let's do this. Come on, right here. Go, go. Gimme. Yeah, what? Yes.
But yeah, it's kind of a shame that you're not doing
the multiplayer thing.
Yeah,
I need to make a, I need to make some kind of account. I need to hire an accountant, is what I hear. John played with the guy who, he didn't know it at the time. He just played with this other person.
Yeah.
And then when he was done, he sent a tweet to the guy who wrote the score saying, really enjoy, I just finished Journey and really enjoyed your score. And the guy says, I just played with you. And he's like, what? And he's like your name was on my list. And he looked on his list, and sure enough, the guy he was playing with was the guy who wrote the score.
That's amazing.
Yeah. Oh my god, I hope I'm not getting sick. That'd be a bummer. Yes. Float. I like it. I'm okay with this. Tom Clancy's Journey? That's ominous. Oh, little fishies. No, look out for him. He'll get you. No. Person that I was playing this with. Be really awesome not to be on this journey all alone.
Can't make me look. Can't make me care. I'm getting the hell out of here. I'm on a journey to find a really big mountain, which, now that I say it out loud, maybe that's a silly reason to go on a journey, but my mountain was very tall, but I was aware there was a taller one, and it had, like, a thing that glowed, so I'm sure you can understand. Okay, we're all on the same page here, right? I need to go to the very tall mountain, and you need to not eat me. In fact, why don't you not look at me? Don't you shine your flashlight on me. Okay, that's flashlights on me. Let's not do that. Ouch. Alright. Sucks. Definitely sucks. Definitely missing my awesome long dong. Oh, I hate you. Not gonna be fun. Now I'm pissed. I don't even want to finish. What's the point?
Just give up.
I'm gonna rage twit. I'm gonna get out there and just say, you know what? I should just tweet out the words, fuck you! And then just say, I'm sorry, that was a rage twit. Yeah, go ahead. I dare you. Fucking try to take it. You can't do it. Too fast. Too fast. Too fast for you, old man. Too fast. Definitely too fast. Too fast for you. Oh! Yeah. Eat that shit, motherfucker. Yes, it is a very tall mountain. And it has a glowing thing on top. Yes. I was thinking that too. No, I do want to... Well, I used to... Back home, I got a big mountain. It's not as big. It's a pretty big mountain, though. I'm just saying, is all. Okay, Chimera. I don't judge your domiciles. Yes, it's more of a hill. A hillock, as it were.
I'm so glad we switched out the televisions. Do you think Bonnie noticed?
I don't know. I mean, they look so similar. How can you possibly notice?
You know what? I'll make you a side bet. I don't think she's gonna notice.
Really?
Great if I could fucking jump at all. I used to be able to jump too. Then someone ate half my long dong. Sigh. Oh, this part was tedious. Yep, I'm definitely calling it here. See all those platforms? You gotta jump on all of them. You miss one, you fall all the way down. And also dragons. So this is a really good time for me to click this little button here.
So have you seen this playthrough before?
I've played it through, yeah. Yeah. But yeah, I played it mainly because just John Tilton loved it. He brought over his PS3. I'm not gonna save it. Because I don't want to have half a dong.
I'd rather have no dong at all than half a dong.
Go full dong or go home?
Go, yes.
That's what I've always
said. I'm pro dong. Deng Xiaoping. Dude, that's what I said, didn't it? There. I wouldn't say it. Maybe it did autosave, but that's just like your opinion, man. No, Brent hasn't murdered me, but we haven't left the state yet. It's going to happen this time, though.
Well, yeah, I mean, the whole plan
Holy crap, do you know who else
here.
has a birthday right now? Comrade Carhax. I haven't seen Comrade Carhax in forever.
Yeah, he kind of disappeared for a while.
Yeah. Good night, lovely, beautiful people. You are... Whoa. Hold on. Monoprice launches a cheap 2560 by 1440 LED backlit for $390. Holy shit, how big are they? What size? 27 inch. Man, that sounds pretty good. What is this? I guess this one I have is only 1920 by, wow, that's amazing.
Well, yes.
Yes, you may. Okay, look, seriously, quit trying to steal me away, you beautiful people. I love you. And for that, we're going to play a little bit of, we'll go old school. Nope, that's not it. All right, bye guys. Gonna be on the road. Now.